going to be third and 10 for Baltimore. Excuse me. Flacco. Flacco under pressure again. And nowhere to go.
Oh, what a time to be alive. The Vikings sit at the NFL's midway point with the best third down defense in the league, thanks to Mike Zimmer's exotic play calling and scheme design. Since taking over for Leslie Frazier, it's no secret, Zimmer's staple look has always been his heavy use of the double A gap blitz on third down, helping them reach in the top 10 in sacks with 22 at the midway point in the season. Let's take a closer look at just a few of these third down stops and what makes the Vikings defense just so hard to convert on. Here against the Packers on 3rd and 7, Zimmer brings 7 defenders to the line of scrimmage. For the 5 offensive linemen, this look is extremely difficult to plan against and requires crystal clear communication from both the center and the quarterback as they are forced to plan against both an all-out blitz or a bluff. Secondly, notice the off coverage by the 3 cornerbacks. They understand where the sticks are, and also because of the heavy rush that is coming, that the ball will likely be out of the quarterback's hands quickly, meaning the receivers won't have time for any double moves or long drawn-out routes. Lastly, and most importantly, check out the safety Anthony Harris. Harris is playing deep, but is over the top and bracketing Jordy Nelson, the slot receiver. Because of the separation between these two, quarterback Brett Hundley knows pre-snap that getting the ball out quickly to Jordy on his seam route is his best option before he feels the inevitable blitz in the backfield. From the snap of the ball, however, you immediately notice linebacker Eric Kendricks fake his blitz and instead drop back into the strong side zone and get underneath Nelson, understanding again that he has the safety Harris over the top of him. This soaks up any quick passing window for Hundley to throw to and forces him to look elsewhere and scan through his progressions. From there, as we scan the field, you'll see Xavier Rhodes keep Devontae Adams in tight coverage and in front of him. On the opposite side, you'll see Geronimo Allison run a fly pattern to clear out Randall Cobb on this out route covered by Mac Alexander. The play design works in the fact that it does create enough separation from Alexander as well as enough open space for a catch and run opportunity past the first down, if the ball is thrown perfectly on time and in stride for Cobb. However, panning back to the backfield, you'll see by this time in the route, both Harrison Smith and Everson Griffin have already collapsed the pocket and have Hundley in their grasps. Zimmer forces opposing quarterbacks to risk a possible interception on the pass attempt, knowing full well that the timing and accuracy of the throw would have to be nearly flawless. A well-designed call by Zimmer, and even better execution by his players, resulting in a sack on third down.
So another third down try for Hundley, and he is hit from behind and hit hard by Harrison Smith again.
Third and 9 against the Baltimore Ravens, and this time Mike Zimmer chooses to show just 4 rushers. Flacco and the O-line are breathing a sigh of relief that for once the Vikings aren't sending extra men on this obvious passing down. Oh, but wait. You'll see both Barr and Kendrick's ever so subtle movement toward the line of scrimmage before the snap, a great disguise, sending a last dash of confusion for this offensive line to account for. Much to the surprise of the Ravens blockers, Zimmer sends both linebackers through the same gap untouched. The key to this blitz, though, is both Griffin and Robinson overcommitting and selling into their blockers in opposite directions, opening up a huge gap like the parting of the Red Sea for their blitzing linebackers. These veterans know they won't be getting the stats this go-around, but are more than happy to free up their teammates, allowing them to fly untouched to the quarterback. Meanwhile, from the All-22, we see tight press coverage from these cornerbacks who know if they can put into action a solid jam and keep their receiver in front of them and tangled up for that extra second, then the pass rush will likely reach Flacco far before his targets can run deep into their routes. Like any blitz, the Vikings leave themselves vulnerable to the tight end here, who is allowed a free release, and his defender safety Andrew Sendejo is giving him nearly 12 yards of cushion due to the fact he must also protect anything deep as he is the last line of defense. Because the tight end doesn't get his head around quickly enough though, Flacco has no shot at firing a quick pass to him in hopes he can do some major damage with his feet. Also, if the Ravens were to have their running back Buck Allen quickly peel out of the flat, Flacco might have been able to connect on a quick swing pass that surely would have gone for a huge gain with no linebackers in sight. These are the things that are easy to see and say in hindsight, however, but the reality is, with all 11 defenders playing as one and so unselfishly, it's easy to see why this could be the best all-around defense in the NFL, and is so hard for opposing offenses to pierce specifically on third downs. That's your quick X's and O's breakdown, doing a deep dive on what makes this Vikings defense so good on third downs. For plenty more Vikings coverage, check out zonecoverage.com. For now, I'm Luke Inman, signing out.
You want to know why they're first in the National Football League in third down defense? You get them in third and long, they're finding different ways to bring pressure and cause confusion by the line. You get a guy clean like that, you have no chance as a quarterback.